Many people would wonder why this name. In fact, he came all the way from Kromanting. His great-grandparents came all the way from this part of the world today called Ghana. Those wonderful Africans who were enslaved and carried all the way to the Caribbean, who got named the Kromantings. Some people call them the Kromanting slaves. They became the Maroons. Now, if you know the story of the wonderful Yah Asantewaa, then you certainly know they were great, wonderful warriors who took over this part of the world. You remember the story of Queen Nanny. You know the story of Ifua. A champion who today in Jamaica is called a compon. Bob Marley came from a powerful family of Maroons, the Kromantings, named after Kromanting, right here in the Republic of Ghana.
The rule the art, you know. When you speak of Rastafari, touch the art.
Bob Marley was born in 9 Mile, St. Anne, Jamaica, on February 6, 1945, even though his passport had it as 6 April, 1945. He was a man who protected and revered his music, as you would see in this mini documentary. Bob Marley is on record to have sent gunmen, known in Jamaica as bad men, to threaten radio disc jockeys to play Bob Marley music, as they seemed to only be interested in playing popular American music.
It was a kind of a struggle. And if a guy shut the door in your face, you gotta find a way to open that door. You know, so sometimes people get roughed up. You know, because you're trying to stop something that is progressive and you don't have a reason to. Why are you trying to hold down the Wailers' music? You can't say why. Why do you play other people's music, but you don't want to play the Wailers' music? You don't say why. Well, we're going to tell you to play it, or you ain't going to work to play nothing. So if you're going to work, remember, you're going to play the Wailers, or when we're going to meet you coming out of work. I'm going to make sure you don't go back to work unless you play the Wailers. Whether we meant it or not, that's how we got some radio play.
Then they put him start to talk and say, you say, you Marlene? Is you call this in a Marlene? From Peter, they with you. Peter, you used to come a jungle, come man, bad man. And now you make Peter stop. And I'm going to say, dude, damn lie. Everybody know that Bob Marley used to man, bad man, but not Peter Tosh.
In recent times, Island Records, the record label that introduced Bob Marley to the world and owned by Chris Blackwell, collaborated with the Bob Marley family to record a series of original Bob Marley remixes featuring the original voice of the legend against the known wish of the spiritual cult legend of Jamaica. In this documentary, I seek to find out from authentic sources if Bob Marley would have sanctioned these remixes if he was alive.
Can't do that to me, man. You're mad. I'm in control. Man can't change. Anybody change, they change from long time, man. They not just change. They will have that change with them. You understand? You know, nothing happen, you know. You just understand everything. Not a thing happen. Whatever you see, it was there before, man.
In 1975, Michael Jackson and the Jackson 5 visited Jamaica for a concert scheduled for 8th March 1975. Marvin Gaye was on the bill, but Bob Marley was the headliner. Yes, Bob Marley was the headliner. Michael Jackson took the opportunity to visit Bob Marley at his home, and Bob Marley was one of his revered idols. He visited Bob Marley at 56 Hope Road, which was Bob Marley's house, and now houses the Bob Marley Museum. In a conversation as recounted by senior band members of Bob Marley's Wailers Band, Michael Jackson asked Bob Marley if they could have a musical collaboration, but Bob Marley laughed it off, saying that their music belonged to two different worlds. Michael Jackson will not give up and will try again years later, as you will see. Remember that reggae music itself emanated from constantly listening to popular American music on the Jamaican radios and trying to invent a local flavor, which was very necessary.
In our sense, we really listen to a lot of music, you know? I mean, first time. So listen to music that play on the radio. Not that we couldn't afford to buy a record, so we listen to the radio. And anything the radio play is that we hear. So I wasn't really into them thing. I was really into, like, you know, call it spiritual music.
They were ambitious enough to say, hey, we're going to make it, we're going to be like the Impressions. Because that's all they listen to most of the time. You go to the studio and you would find them listening to Curtis Mayfield, James Brown, you know, and listening. Then Coxon would bring us a pile of records from America. And to us that was, woo, we're listening to American music.
Reggae music metamorphosed from ska all through rocksteady to blue beat and even more before becoming reggae in no particular order.
When the musicians in Jamaica started to play, a lot of them can play calypso too, because they play a lot of calypso. But because the American influence music come past you down there, you know, them start to kind of get more to them time you start Fats Domino.
Yes.
And plenty of them type of people. So after a while now, the music start drift from the reggae. So it used to be a music almost like a half blues. And used to play before the ska start, you know. Even people like Joe Hicks, janana, 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 you know that music?
Right.
Used to play that plenty.
Uh-huh.
So, from there now it developed to people start ching, 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 for ska, you know. And then for rock steady is like ching, ching, ching. For reggae now it's ching, 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 you know.
Nevertheless, as soon as reggae music was created, the island of Jamaica seemed to abandon American popular music and stick to the new baby, making Bob Marley and the other pioneering proponents of reggae instant heroes. Rastafari took center stage and the music became spiritualized, as Bob Marley mentioned in his music and in several interviews.
It's the feel, you know? It carry a feel where if you ask plenty musician, them know it, but them can't do it. So people still searching for this truth here, which this reggae music, you know, bring across to them. And the only purpose it serves is to tell the people about Rastafari.
There was a time when we were what you would call imperfect in the music. We was learning the music that comes through divine inspiration, not the one that had been influenced.
Because the messages that we carried, you know, were of the same context. You know, we were just messages of the same, talking about the same divine one.
Did I hear the words of a higher man say?
Bob Marley is on record to have said that his music was poles apart from Barry White's and did not wish to share fans as captured in this interview.
See, you can't love my music to love reality, you know. You can't love my music like how you don't love Barry White music. It's different people love my music from the people who love Barry White music. Music never just come for vain, you know.
That's right. A serious thing.
No, music never just come for vain.
Babylon throne gone down, gone down. Babylon throne gone down.
Barry White himself was a huge legend of American music. And he had a huge following. A very, very huge following, very loyal to Barry White's music. Well, it is clear that Bob Marley did not want to dilute his music, both spiritually and creatively. After the passing of Bob Marley, the Marley family fell into a huge debt. And remembered that Michael Jackson was a huge fan of Bob and decided to see him for a loan. This was when Jackson requested to buy the whole catalog of Bob Marley, probably refusing to accept he could not have a collaboration with Bob Marley whilst he was alive. What a close shave. The Marley family was divided in the selling of Bob's catalog. So, the deal never materialized and Jackson lost one more time. Poor Michael Jackson. Does this sound like a Bob Marley who would be happy having people from all kinds of genres and spirituality enter into his private music space? Remember that Bob Marley said in this interview that his music was very, very personal to him.
So me always a Rasta from creation. So Rasta is the whole thing, is not an influence. Rasta the thing, everything, every other thing. We don't know what going on about the other thing then. Rasta the first. People fight me and they work better for me. Because when them fight me, you can't go sit down and meditate of what they're fighting me for and make a song of it. Or you think me right, I'll shot the sheriff and all them things. Just the fight with me, I get in my own group.
I am of the opinion that the legend Bob Marley would be unhappy with all these invasions. It is actually better called desecration.
I'm good to love it. Cause her son had been shot down in the street and died.
Check it, I grew up a fucking screw up. Got introduced to.
Would I have said the same thing about Peter Tosh's compatriot and a former bandmate? No, I wouldn't. Why? Much as Peter Tosh was very militant, he in 1978 featured a known bisexual and a user of recreational drugs, Mick Jagger, in his work Don't Look Back, knowing very well that Rastafari was against homosexuality, bisexuality, and also the use of recreational drugs. He still went ahead and featured Mick Jagger. Mick Jagger was the henchman of the famous Rolling Stones band, larger than life, very talented. Peter Tosh featured him for clout, probably, and maybe for a breakthrough into the British and American markets, and this is clear. If the Peter Tosh family decides to recreate Peter Tosh's songs featuring his original voice, I will have very little qualms, as the man himself initiated that, though on only one known song during his lifetime. Lest I forget. What happened to Bob Marley's wish to be in Ethiopia for the rest of his life, close to Haile Selassie as possible, as head in this interview?
As a Rasta, what is your feeling about being Jamaican?
Being Jamaican?
Yeah.
Being Jamaican, well, years gone on, Neville. Being Jamaican, I don't say being Jamaican, you know. I see myself as a Rasta, being Rasta.
Uh-huh.
You know. Yeah. So Jamaica is Jamaica, Africa is Africa. I'm an Rasta.
Uh-huh. You don't have any boundaries.
My boundaries? No, well, I must pick a place on earth where I know I must live, uh-huh. And I know I want to live near my father, and my father live in Ethiopia.
Yeah.
So I must live where my father is.
Literally, in other words, literally, you hope to go and live in Ethiopia someday?
I don't hope. We're going. And near.
Oh, I'm telling you, rebel music.
Rita Marley, the wife of Bob Marley, mooted the idea of reburying Bob in Ethiopia. But the Jamaican government and some individuals passionately refused and even threatened Rita Marley. She tried, but she was refused. No wonder she built a beautiful Bob Marley studio in Africa and relocated to Ghana, where I was her best friend. Oh, her son. Long live the legend Bob Marley. And please, please again, respect the legacy of Bob Marley. Stop desecrating his legacy.
They said the Zion train is coming our way. Got the ticket to thank the Lord.
After watching this mini documentary, I am sure that a lot of people would see where we are coming from. A lot of people would wear the shoes of Bob Marley. Many people have asked me, are you wiser than the Bob Marley family? And the question I ask them back is the Bob Marley family wiser than Bob Marley himself? The man said he didn't want it. His family says, it must be done. That's the question we are asking. Now that you know, what would you do? The burden of knowledge. How would this story impact your lives today? The burden of knowledge. Now that you know, what would you do? Be an any olea, mini oba fe, ye zunda kagane, meza kaine, ye ain pa bango, bukaya nan, fifi ainya, no kaina wo, banaehu, ebeden. Banaehu, ebeya bade, lele anjima singa be kune, lele anjima singa beri. It's been the African history class.
Ila ila chinde la lenywa ila muwa matinda batomu nda bi pete pete kaba wela ne Jesu bi ngwene ngwene kaba wela no ila ila chinde la lenywa wa Jesu bien ngwene ngwene kaba wela no ila ila chinde la lenyo awa.